Hi everyone, in this video we're going to be talking about the User Archives option for WinCC. I'm in version 8. User Archives is a recipe system. So basically you build a database which can interact with your PLC. So here our User Archive represents cookie recipes. So from the user interface, the operator could choose a recipe, and then from the toolbar, they could download that recipe into tags, which are seen by the PLC. Now the PLC logic knows the recipe for shortbread cookies in this case. We can make shortbread cookies. You can also select recipes and use your own custom buttons using direct connects to download recipes. You can also have the PLC logic change the recipe. Let's say that in this case, for the oatmeal cookies, it concluded that we only need 15 pounds of flour. Then we could upload that and notice that we've updated the recipe. So this is a two-way communication between your PLC and your database. Now, we also have the concept of control tags. Control tags will allow the PLC to download, upload, delete records in the database. So basically you just create these control tags and you can say the PLC decides it wants to download this number 2 shortbread. So we put in 7 into the job and 2 into the ID. The PLC executes it. Now it has downloaded that ID. It can also do an upload just by changing the tags. So let's say that the flour needs to change back to 24. We could just do a job number 6. And you can see it did update that to 24. Now the PLC can actually do a lot more. I'm going to show you later in this video. It can actually look up a record based on one of the field names. It can also just grab the latest record or the first record, however you want this to process. So User Archives is insanely easy to set up. It is one of my favorite options. I think it's probably one of the more popular options. It's been around for a long time. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to set it up, how to build this screen, and how to create your control interface for your PLC. So if this sounds interesting to you, let's get started. So we're going to go back to Control Center, and I'm just going to point out in License Manager, you do need a User Archives license for this option. I don't know offhand how much it costs, but it is worth every penny if you need a recipe system. And it can also be used to generate production records. And usually this is keeping a record of objects as they're manufactured or refurbished or reworked as they go through the production process. I'm going to be covering this use case in an upcoming video, so be sure to watch for that. Also, if you find value in this, I would really appreciate it if you would hit that subscribe button, like this video, share it with your friends, and allow me to keep bringing you this content. So the first thing that we're going to do is we'll go to our startup list, so our computer server properties, and you have to make sure that User Archives is checked so that the service runs during runtime. We will go ahead and do that. I'm going to take us out of runtime. Now that we're out of runtime, I'm going to open up the User Archive Editor. And first, we're going to create our archive. I'm just going to call it Cookies. And you want to go to Communication Type, and you're not able to add tags until you do this. We can either use raw data tags or data manager tags. We will choose data manager. And then we need to define a few things in the archive. So, namely, I want to check last access and last user. This will give me a date timestamp every time the user archive is changed. Now, these are your PLC control tags. I already have these created. Typically, these are PLC tags so that the PLC can read and write these tags to control the download, upload, and management of the archive. So I'm just going to browse over here. And I have already created these. So there's my ID tag. Here is my job tag, my field tag, and the value tag. And we will see how to use these a little later in the video. Now, once I have this done, what we want to do is we'll expand over here, choose our archive, and we need to create our fields. So these are going to be the fields of the table that you're creating. So we need a description, which is going to be the name. And that is going to be a string. And for this particular one, this is how I'm going to tell my recipes apart. So I am going to require that it has a value, because you don't have to have a value for every field value. And it has to be unique. That way I can't have two recipes with the same name. And we're going to index it. And basically, if we have a lot of recipes, indexing speeds up the database. So we will just add that in. The next field that we want is going to be flavor ID. And this is just going to be an ID of the type of flavor that goes into it. We're going to leave this as a number and an integer. I'm not going to worry about setting up as an index. And we can put minimum and maximum values in here for error checking. You can do a start value and things like that. We need to put in our tag name. And like I said, I've created these before. So this is going to be our flavor ID. And I'll go back to description because I forgot to do that. Here's our description. Make sure it's the correct data type. And then after flavor ID, we need flour. And that is also going to be a number. We're going to choose our tag name. Here's our flour. And then number of eggs. This is also going to be a number. We're going to choose our tag here. Then finally, sugar. And we will set it to our sugar tag. Now that we have our archive defined, we're going to go over to archive data, and you can see it's kind of built us a table. And this table actually exists in your project runtime database. So let's add in some recipes. So I'll say for my chocolate, my flavor ID is going to be 12. It's going to be 13 pounds of flour. It's going to be 45 eggs and 12 pounds of sugar. And then the next one, we're just going to add shortbread. And let's say it's 15 flavor ID, 17 pounds of flour, 36 eggs, and 16 pounds of sugar. We'll do ginger snaps. I don't like to put spaces in there. I don't know if it'll let you. So I want to put in ginger snaps here, but it's saying that there's a max 10 characters. So let's go back to the definition and see my description here. Let's make this 20. So now we can go back to our archive data and put in ginger snaps. And so for ginger snaps, we will say that is flavor ID 13, 14 pounds of flour, 40 eggs, and 20 pounds of sugar. And then let's do one more, my all-time favorite, oatmeal, no raisins. And that is going to be flavor ID 19. We will do 16 of flour, 22 eggs, and 9 pounds of sugar. So we actually have data in our archives now. So now that we have this done, I'm going to close the archive editor and we're going to go into graphics designer. And I already have a page prepared. I know that most of you guys have been working with WinCC. You know how to put IO fields. So let me just kind of show you around. This user archives control, you're going to find this on your control palette and it's right here. And basically when you pull this out, I'm not going to pull it out. I'm just going to double click this guy. All you have to do is just go pick your archive. And it will automatically set all your columns up and you can choose which ones you want. You can also configure your font. Like I've got mine set a little bit high at 27. Look at your columns. And you can also set which toolbar that you have. So it's a pretty easy setup. You can just kind of make this look the way that you want. If we go and look at these PLC tags, these are the tags that we defined for each of our fields. So we've got UA cookies description. I just kind of named them like that. Really good idea to have a naming convention. There's my flavor ID. There's my flour. There's my eggs. There's my sugar. So the idea is these are PLC tags. When you download a record, it goes in these tags. Now your PLC program has them and it can do its job now that it knows. Now on the download and upload to process, if we look at these are just direct connects. And I've used this trick before. I'm going to throw up a video where I show you how to do this on the alarm control. For all the controls in WinCC, for your editors, alarm logging, tag logging, user archives, there is a toolbar button click property. So what you have to do is go find the number of the button that you want to emulate. In this case, this is the download to process or the write tags button. That's 13. Or if we want to do upload, that's 12. So if you want to know how to do this, We'll just go to the properties. I'll go over to the toolbar. And so for write tags, you see that is object ID 13. That's our download. Read tags, that's 12. That's our upload. So that's how I got that. So we don't have to write any scripting. Here, as you might have guessed, this is where your control tags are. So these pretty much need to be PLC driven unless you're doing this all internally. So there's my ID and my job. And the field and value. And the field and value tags are what allows you to have your PLC code actually look up a record based on, say, a description or some other parameter. So you can really get a lot out of this. You don't actually have to have the operator uploading and downloading recipes. You can have your PLC doing it. So I'm going to be showing you all of these control tag features in a moment. Now that we have our screen created, I'm just going to save this and we will go into runtime. And so now we're in runtime, and I'm going to go to our user archives page. It is showing our user archive there with our data that we put into the editor. And you see that our archive is there. It's got our data that we put into the editor, and we can select and download to the process. We can make changes to the process and upload these. So let's talk a little bit more about the control tags, because these are really powerful. The control tags allow the PLC to interact with the user archives. It can do a lot of stuff. First, let's find out how we know what commands are possible. So I'm going to open up the help file. And I tried searching for control tags, but you just have to know. You go under Options, User Archive, and go to Properties of User Archive, and scroll all the way down. And this explains how the control tags work. So it's a little hard to find in help. So the ID is the data record, 6, 7, and 8 are your job command. 6 is read from the tags into the database, 7 is take from the database, go to the PLC tags, 8 is delete. But then we have field and value. This allows the PLC to actually look up a record. So going back into runtime, we would set our ID to 0, or the PLC would in this case. And let's say that we wanted to download the oatmeal recipe. So in our field, the PLC would write in, look for the recipe where the description field value equals oatmeal. So it doesn't know what the ID is, but it knows it wants to download oatmeal. Now we just do a job 7, which is your download, and it's going to download the oatmeal recipe. Now it could also, of course, make changes to it and do a job 6 to it. And here we've updated our flour to 12. So the field and value actually allows your PLC to make a very simple query on the records. Now, of course, you're going to use a field that has unique values so that it's going to load one record. Going back to help, you see that we can also do things like create records. So if we do an ID of -1, whatever is in our archive tags for our fields will actually create a new record if we do a job 6. So let's take a look at that. Let's say that the PLC has refined a recipe to run, say, a bigger batch or something, and so it wants to do oatmeal version 2. So what it would do is, in our description field, it would put in the description V2, and it would put in the flavor ID and values for each of the fields that were relevant for this version 2 of the recipe. And then we would just do a -1, which tells us we are going to write a record, and we would do a job 6. And it's going to add a brand new record with these values into our archive. So the PLC has the ability to add records as well as delete records. So we could also go back and delete this record if we wanted to, just by, say, putting in ID number 6 and a job number 8, and it would go out and delete that record. Looking back at the help file, you can also read the lowest or highest ID. This is really useful if you want to get the latest record or the first record. You could do different jobs on these or delete them or something like that. So let's say that shortbread is loaded and we need to get the latest record. Then we could do a -9, and we could do a job 7, and it's going to download the latest record, which is oatmeal. Now, if we did a -6 here, which is get the lowest record with the ID, then we could also do a job 7. It's going to download chocolate because that's the lowest ID. And of course, we could go in and delete these. Another thing that you can do is you can export data directly from this control. That's going to give you your archive stuff. So you can just export the data as a CSV file, and then you can pull it back in, or you can move it between projects. You can export it and edit it in, say, Excel, do all your recipes there, and then bring it back in. So that's pretty useful. So that's a pretty good run through of exactly what User Archives is. It is insanely easy to set up. Got a working example here. Now, there's more that you can do with this because it's in the database. You can use VBS scripting to do a lot of these functions. A lot of people write scripts that just manipulate your control tags, so you're not having to do database programming. You can do that. There's also a C interface for this. I'm going to tell you it's better to go with VBS than C because the C interface to this is kind of dated and it's a little bit difficult to use, especially if you don't know C programming. In some upcoming videos, I'm going to be going over doing some VBS scripts with User Archives. I've got a WinCC database programming class coming up, which will also cover this module as well as database programming. So keep an eye out for that. And if you learned something here, please consider subscribing, liking this video, sharing this with colleagues so I can bring this training to more people. Thank you for watching.